Hello mga ka-powerbank, and once again this is Teacher Jesse, at sa video na to ang pag-uusapan natin ay tungkol sa visualizing multiplication of fractions. Ito ay ang module 5 ng quarter 1 math 5. Okay, so sa mga hindi pa nakapag-subscribe na aking channel, huwag kalimutang mag-subscribe and click nyo din ang notification bell para lagi kayong updated sa mga math tutorial videos na i-upload ko. Huwag nyo rin kalimutang i-like ang aking video kung natuto kayo, and then please share naman para makita rin ang mga mag-aaral natin nag-aaral ngayong may pandemya. Mahirap kasi ngayon kasi canceled pa ang mga face-to-face classes. So, kahit pa paano, makatulong din sa kanila ang video na to. Okay, so simulan na natin. Let's start with the drill. What you're going to do is i-add nyo or subtract nyo mentally ang mga fractions na ipapakita ko sa inyo. So, bibigyan ko kayo ng isang example, and then, kayo na yung susunod. Let's start with 1/8 plus 3/5. So, gagamitin natin ang butterfly method. Are you familiar with this? So, ang gagawin natin is cross-multiply lang natin. 1 times 5, which is 5, and then 3 times 8 is equal to 24. Tapos, i-add natin yung dalawa. Ito rin pala, 8 times 5 is equal to 40. So, i-add natin yung dalawa, 24 plus 5 is 29, and then, kopyahin na lang natin itong 40. So, the answer is 29 over 40. Kung hindi pa naka-simplest form, reduce lang natin to simplest form. Okay, are you ready? Sige, let's start. Let's have 1/9 plus 1/10. Go! Okay, so the correct answer is 10 times 1 is 10, and then 9 times 1 is 9, and then 9 times 10 is 90. So it means 10 times 10 plus 1 is equal 10 plus 9 rather, sorry, is equal to 19, and then copy this 90. Kapag unit fractions, may mas mabilis pa dyan. Ang gagawin nyo lang, kung unit fractions, when you say unit fractions, yung mga numerator niya ay 1. So ang gagawin mo lang, 9 plus 10 is equal to 19, tapos 9 times 10 is equal to 90. Di ba? Mas mabilis. Okay. Let's have another one. 1/3 minus 1/5. Go. Okay, so the answer is 5 times 1 is 5, and then 3 times 1 is 3. 5 minus 3 is 2, and then 3 times 5 is equal to 15. So the answer is 2 over 15. Okay, next. We have 2/5 plus 1/6. Go. Okay, so the correct answer is 6 times 2 is 12, and then 5 times 1 is equal to 5, and then 6 times 5 is 30, 12 plus 5 is equal to 17, and then kopyahin mo lang 30, 17 over 30. Okay, so I hope that you got the correct answers. Okay, let's proceed now with the lesson 1, which is visualizing multiplication of fractions. Okay, mahirap tong visualizing kung titingnan natin. Kasi sanay tayo diretso na alam kasi natin ang process niyan is multiply numerator time by the other numerator, and then denominator times the denominator. Ganun. Pero how about if we are asked to visualize multiplication of fractions using the models or the illustration or diagrams? Okay, let's try the first part of our module, which is the let us try. Understand the illustration of multiplication, multiplying fractions, and then write through if the tiling and the shading is correct and false if it is wrong. Let's start with the number 1. 1/2 times 1/4. Ganito daw ang itsura. And ito yung daw yung sagot. Okay, itong color blue. Yan ang ano, intersection nila. Okay, do you have any idea kung paano mag-visualize? Okay, yan. So, since it is let us try activity, just try to answer and then compare natin sa correct answer. Anyway, I will reveal the answer now. Okay, dito, this is true daw. This one is also true. And the third one is 4/5 times 1/2 is also true. And the other one is false. And the other one is also false. Okay, bakit kaya naging false tong dito? Okay, anyway, later on, madi-discover natin kung bakit yan may mga mali sa illustration. Let's start with the let us study activity. So read and understand this problem as we focus our activity on the visualizing multiplication of fractions using model. So this is now the problem. Mother bought 4/5 kilogram of meat. She used 2/3 of it in cooking pinakbet. How much meat did mother use? So bumili siya ng 4/5 kilogram, tapos 2/3 of it ang ginamit niya. 2/3 ng 4/5. So the question is, how much meat did mother use? So anong gagawin natin? So if you are going to encounter a problem like this, it involves multiplication kasi kailangan mong kunin yung 4/5 ng 2/3 ng 4/5. Okay, hindi ito 4/5 minus 2/3. Okay, ang ibig sabihin niyan is we are going to multiply this 4/5 with by this 2/3. So ang gagawin natin, it is what is 2/3 of 4/5. Okay, kunin natin 4/5 kasi ang unang nakasulat dyan. So ito yung kukunan natin ng 2/3. Okay? So to visualize this, ganito yung itsura niya. Magiging 2/3 of 4/5. So 4/5, so drawing ka muna ng 4/5. Ayan, 1 2 3 4 5. 5 parts. 4 parts are shaded. And then, kukunan mo ng 2/3 ito. So, paano ba ang 2/3? So, para hindi ka mahirapan, ang gagawin natin is drawing tayo ng horizontal this time. Kasi, vertical na to, patayo. So, pahiga na naman. Which is 2/3. So, ayan. We have 2/3. Kailangan magsing laki sila. Yung dalawang boxes. Ayan. Or ang tawag natin dito is models. Yung dalawang models dapat exactly the same. So, yan. Although, opposite ang kanilang pag-divide into parts. Ang purpose niyan, bakit opposite, vertical and horizontal, para makuha natin ang intersection. Okay? Kung ilang parts ang intersection nila. So, ang gagawin natin this time is ilalagay natin itong dito, itong 2/3, para makuha natin ang intersection. So, magiging ganito. Yan, ilipat natin. Yung itsura niya. Ilipat natin. And then, next is, kukunin natin yung intersection. So, yan. Kasi merong naputol kasi yung line dito kasi natabunan ng red. So, magiging orange na yan. Ayan. Combination, kumbaga, ng red and yellow, magiging orange. So, focus tayo dito sa parts na naging orange intersection. Okay? So, kung titingnan natin, hanggang dito yung intersection niya. So, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 parts. Ito, wala kasing intersection. Yellow lang yan, tsaka red lang yan. Hindi na natin yan bibilangin, isulat sa numerator. Pero, bibilangin natin ang kabuuan, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So, 8 out of 15. Or in other words, 3 times 8 is 15. Ang total niyan, yung total number of total number of parts, kailangan yung product ng dalawang denominators. So, 3 times 5 is 15. Tapos, ang shaded parts is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8. It means, it is 8 out of 15. Okay? So, yan yung process ng visualizing multiplication of fractions. Let's have another example. Like, for example, Alan spent 1/2 of an hour doing his assignment. He spent 3/4 of it doing math. How much did he spend doing his assignment in math? Yan, 1/2 of an hour ginamit niya sa paggawa ng assignment. Tapos 2/3 nun, nung 1/2 hour is sa paggawa lang ng math. So, kailangan nating multiply na naman. Okay, what is 2/3 of this 1/2? So, what is 2/3 of 1/2? So, drawing ka muna ng 1/2. Unahin natin si 1/2. And then 2/3. So, ayan ang yung 1/2. 2/3 nun. So, drawing tayo ng 2/3. Ayan ang 2/3. Tapos, ito yung intersection. So, there are 1, 2 out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, it is 2 out of 6. Or, divide mo lang ng 2. Divide mo 2 kasi kailangan mo reduce into simplest form. So, magiging 1/3. Okay? So, the answer is 1/3. Ayan. Another example. But by the way, kung titingnan natin ang picture or ang diagram, kaya magiging 1/3 to kasi kung kunwari lipat natin tong green dito sa part kasi dalawang parts kasi yan shaded. Kunwari ilalagay natin dito yung green na yan papunta dito, parang one hole lang shaded tapos tatlong parts sila. So yan, 1, 2, 3. Okay, imagine nyo lang na ilipat nyo yung green dito, kaya 1/3. Yan rin ang visualizing simplest form or reducing simplest form of a fraction. Okay, anyway, proceed tayo sa another example. What is 1/4 of 3/5? So, yan. Drawing muna natin ang 3/5. And then, importante, unahin natin tong dito, yung 3/5. Kasi ang kukunin natin ay ang sangkapat or 1/4 ng 3/5. So, wag natin unahin si 1/4. Si 3/5 talaga. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then, kukunin natin ang 1/4 niyan. So, hatiin natin into 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ayan. Hatiin na sa 4. Then, shade natin yung isang part. Ayan. Tapos, kunin natin ang intersection. So, there are 1, 2, 3. 3 out of 4 times 5 is 20. So, it is 3 out of 20 or 3 over 20. So, yan yung pag-visualize. Okay? So, proceed tayo sa let us practice activity ng module. Look at the overlapping section of the tiles that represents the product of two fractions. So, ito yung mga illustration. A, letter B, C, D, and E. So, ang gagawin natin, hahanapin daw natin ang alin ba dito yung numbers or expression or number sentence dito sa mga diagrams. Okay? So, do you have any clue kung paano natin hahanapin? Okay, so, unang gagawin natin, kailangan kumpletuhin muna natin itong mga linyang to na broken. So, kagaya nito. Or, putol. Kagaya nito, mayroon talagang linya yan para maging equal sila kalaki. Ayan. So, dito rin. Yan o, kasi putol. Tsaka dito. Kasi ito, okay na to. Okay na rin to. So, dito. So, yan. Okay. Next is, ang pinakamadaling technique dito na gagawin natin is bilangin lang natin tong ilang parts ba dito na side. Pababa, yung 1, 2, 3. Sanapin mo dito yung may denominator na 3. Ayan. Ayan. Ganyan lang kasimple yan. Kasi ang ibig sabihin yan, 6, 7 of 2 halves. So, 2 halves, ibig sabihin, kagaya nito number 1, 2 halves. So, 2 out of 2. So, ito yung, syempre, ito lang yung 2 out of 2. Itong parts na ito, 1 and 2. Kasi yung iba, 3 na yan. Kasi diba dito tayo mag-focus pag hinanap natin yung, ang ibig sabihin kasi ng 6, 7 of 2 halves is, what is 6, 7 of 2 halves? What is 3 fourths of 5, 6? Kagaya nito, 5, 6. So, ibig sabihin, i-drawing mo talaga una yung 5, 6. So, hanapin mo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Obviously, hindi na yan. So, ito na talaga. Okay? So, yun yung technique niyan. Kaya napakalali lang. So, ang task lang dito is just identifying the correct diagram. So, start tayo dito sa number 1, which is 2 halves. So, bilangin mo lang. Ayan ang 2. So, letter D. Next, 6. Ayan. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ayan na kagad. Letter B. 3. Ayan, 1, 2, 3. Next, 5. So, ayan, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ayan. And, next is 3. Ayan, 1, 2, 3. Ah, 3 pala itong dalawa. Yung letter A at saka letter C. Kaya lang 5, 6 ang hinahanap dito sa letter C. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5, 6. Ayan. Dito kasi, sa 3/4 of 5/6. 3/4, ayan. 6, letter B. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ayan. Kasi pareha sila 6. 3. Ay, saan ba yun yung kaparehas 3? 3. Ay, ayan. Letter C. 5, 6, tsaka 1, 8 pala. Sorry. Letter A, 1, 8. So, ayan. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ayan. Okay, so letter A ito, ang number 3, and letter C ang number 5. Ayan. Okay, how about if kunin talaga natin yung mga product? Okay, going back to this problem. So, kung kukunin natin talaga ang mga products, ang gagawin natin is Ganun lang. Halimbawa, number 1, letter D. Ito yung diagram. So, bibilangan lang natin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 out of 14. Pag simplify natin, it is divided by 2, divided by 2, which is 6 over 7. Okay? Next is, ito, letter B. Tingnan natin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15 out of 24 kasi 6 times 4 is 24. Ang intersection. Pwedeng ma-divide sa 3. So, magiging 15 divided by 3 is 5 and 24 divided by 3 is 8. Number 3, A. Ayan. So, 1, 2. Dalawa out of 24 kasi 8 times 3 is 24 yan. So, magiging divided by 2, 1. Divided by 2, 12. Next, number 4, E. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 ang shaded parts na intersection. And then, out of 5 times 4 is 20. So, 4 over 20. Pwede pang ma-divide ng 4. 4 divided by 4 is 1. And 20 divided by 4 is 5. And finally, letter C. So, yan. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 out of 18. Wala nang pwedeng makadivide niyan. So, this is simplest form. 5 over 18 na talaga ang answer. Okay, so by illustration, madali lang nating nakuha ang answer. Although, alam naman natin na 6 times 2 is equal to 12. Ganyan talaga yan. 7 times 4 is equal to 14. Eh, meron nga akong ginawang isang video pa tungkol dyan. But anyway, ganun lang ang gagawin natin. So, how about let us practice more? So, this time, illustrate natin ang problem. Siguro, take lang tayo ng number 1 problem. Anyway, ganun pa rin naman ang steps. Ganun pa rin nung mga pinakita ko sa kaninang mga examples. Let's take this 1/9 times 1/2. So, it is 1/9. What is 1/9 of 1/2? So, drawing muna natin ang 1/9. Ayan, 1/9. And then, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then, 1 part is shaded. And 1/2, so yan ang kalahati. So, yan ang point of intersection. So, this is 1 out of 18. So, the answer is 1 over 18. Kaya lang, illustrate lang pala. So, ayan yung answer. Okay. So, anyway, kung ipasasolve, ganun pa rin, 1 over 18. Kunwari, kailangan talaga inilagay ang answer. Okay. And we are now down to the last activity, which is the let us assess. So, visualize the following. For numbers 1 and 2, shade down natin ang figure based on our answer. So, ayan, nakasulat na kagad. Tapos may drawing na. Shade na lang natin. So, napakadali lang gawin. So, 2/4. Shade mo lang 2/4. And then, 1/3. Shade mo lang ang 1/3. And then, combination. So, ayan. Yung dalawang parts na yan ang shaded. Okay? And number 2. What about this one? 3/8 times 2/7. So, 2/7. Shade mo lang dalawang parts. Then, 3/8. 1, 2, 3. And then, combine mo lang. So, dalawa kasi yan. So, dalawang shade din dito ang shade mo lang. Tapos, 3 dito. Ayan. Ayan. So, this is our answer. So, ganun lang kasimple ang ating gagawin pag visualizing. Okay? So, that's it for today. And I hope that you have learned something. Please like and share this video if you have learned something. And huwag niyo rin kalimutang mag-subscribe sa aking channel para lagi kayong updated sa aking mga math tutorial videos na i-upload. See you next time!